Hey, 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 welcome back to Brick System Brothers. My name's Nathan Masters. Today I wanted to do a short walkthrough on how to add a Bricklink wanted list into Rebrickable for the purpose of part inventory. This video is kind of brought about by a question we had from Robo Knight on an earlier video, and just specifically related to, you know, converting things between these different websites that help a lot with getting things down to the individual piece level. So let's jump right into this. I'm going to start on Bricklink. I have 3001 pulled up, and I just wanted to add in one of these pieces to my default wanted list so that you guys could kind of track one piece all the way through the process. So let's add this to my default wanted list, chrome gold, any condition, add it in, and let's just go jump to that list real quick. We can see I've got quite a few different things on here. A large base plate, the chrome gold brick we just added, and some other random pieces. So for the most part, pieces that I'm kind of tracking, I want to add in at some point, but this will be kind of our example today in terms of following all the way through. All right, so this is the Bricklink XP website, and it's important to differentiate between Bricklink XP and classic Bricklink because that will play an important role in this process. The Bricklink XP website has kind of an updated UI, user interface. It's a little bit smoother process between certain things. As far as, you know, the multi-buy function, I think that's more prominent on this site. And so the actual buyer experience is kind of what LEGO is focusing on now that they have purchased Bricklink. There's nothing wrong with that. I'm learning my way through Bricklink XP. But for this process, you're going to want to scroll down and click on Switch to Classic right down there. And now we are on the original kind of layout. So the classic version of Bricklink still exists. It's still supported and out there. It's just a matter of scrolling down. If you end up on Bricklink XP, scrolling down to classic, and a lot of people that have used Bricklink for a long time probably still have this in their shortcuts somewhere in their favorites. So yeah, as long as you're on Bricklink Classic, this should work just fine. Let's go to our default wanted list here on Bricklink Classic and click on this download button. And this will give you an option to name a file as an XML document. So I'll call this default. And now jump over to your Rebrickable account. And it will be helpful to know your way around Rebrickable now that we are kind of bringing things over to this website. So kind of a background in both websites is a good place to start, but you should be able to follow this if you're new. So I have my loose parts up here, kind of a shortcut in the tabs, and you organize loose parts by a part list. I'm going to create a brand new list. Let's just call this Bricklink Wanted List. Save the part list. And now we're going to use the import delete pop-up, which opens up kind of this window here. And don't be distracted down at the bottom where it has an import from website. This is handy when you have an order placed already from BrickOwl or Bricklink. And it works pretty well, but a wanted list is not an order. So we need to go up here and upload a file from the disk. I've got it in my videos folder. Here is the default. We'll open this up. And now we just click append parts. It has the import results down here. A couple of warnings that some parts were changed. This is just related to how the different websites map the pieces on the internal side of things. Everything else should be the same. And now we'll just close this out and we can see that the wanted list has been brought into Rebrickable, kind of to convert it all automatically to their scheme where things are hyperlinked, everything is very closely tied together, tied to set inventories. That's how we can tell certain pieces are more uncommon or more rare. So all that works quite well within this framework. And just doing a quick comparison, 12 unique lots and 21 total quantity. Let's go back on here and kind of inspect. We've got 12 items found, and just counting through, you know, having 8 copies of the fence here, everything else I think is a single copy. That gives us 21 total quantity. So everything works well here, converted over nicely. You will probably encounter pieces here and there that do not convert so smoothly, but a good starting point just in terms of, again, downloading this, from the Bricklink Classic version of the website, and then using the import function to select the downloaded file that you have on your computer. Just go ahead and skip the import from website for now, because that is actually related to orders. Want to list orders, not the same thing. So, hope that is helpful. Robo Knight, to answer your question, and anyone else who may be watching. Thanks for tuning in today on Brick System Brothers, and we will see you around the channel.